Good morning, everybody. In due respect to the chairperson and His Royal Highness Chief Olumpuma, as I have been told my names are Kalela Alex. I was the head teacher for the hearing impaired. That's the children with the hearing impairments. School for the others, they call it school for the deaf in Kaloloshi. So I was used to sign the language. So we are using sign the language to teach our children. Thank you very much. So I'm going to talk about corporate social responsibilities, then the needs in Lufanyama. The social responsibilities rendered to us by various companies which are operating in Lufanyama district. It's okay. You can do without it. It's okay. Let's just go ahead. So, as you can see from the map, Lufanyama is the largest district in the Copperbelt province. It shares boundaries with Mpongwe, Lwansha, Kitwe, Kaloloshi, and Chingola. Also in the western part of the district, we have Sorwezi. So most of the people in Lufanyama district are subsistence farmers. They grow a variety of crops, ranging from maize, sorghum, sweet potatoes, to name just a few. The district has about 400 miners operating in Lufanyama. Most of these miners are not producing anything due to lack of equipment. They are too poor to afford the large equipment such as excavators, front loaders, and the others. So we have a lot of challenges in Lufanyama, and most of the challenges that we have is related, some of them are related to drinking water and sanitation. So most people in Lufanyama have to travel long distances to reach where they can get safe drinking water. We have boreholes quite okay, but they are not enough to cater for everybody in the district. The lack of employment. Most of our youth are not employed. Then your cast. Decent housing units. We do not have enough accommodation for our members of staff. So most of the people commute from nearby towns, Kaloloshi and Kitwe, because we don't have accommodation for our staff. So even myself, I do commute. I don't have accommodation in Lufanyama. So appealing to the stakeholders, please, those of the capital, the government be investing in Fanyama by putting up structures for rent. Civil servants are ready to rent their houses in Fanyama. They want to stay in Fanyama, but they are not able to do so because there is no accommodation. So if there are some people who have money, who are willing to assist the people of Fanyama, they have to come to Fanyama very gradually, give them land in which to construct houses. And then apart from that, we don't have social facilities. We don't have, for example, hotels, guest houses. We have one popular guest house, but that is just a grass patch. So we don't have guest houses. We need people to come there, and those who are able to construct guest houses, and I'm sure they will make a lot of money, because that will be the only better guest house. Most of the people, as I said, they are subsistence farmers. They don't have much income. They depend mainly on farm produce. So that's not enough. So the people who are operating in Fanyama, we want them at least to help in uplifting the standards of our people by offering them employment. The only part, the only situation that which is adversely affecting the employment of our people is that some of them lack education. We have jobs quite alright which can be given to our local people. Those which doesn't require skills. So those who are operating in Fanyama, we would like them to employ our people, not to make excuses, because we have got the people can do certain jobs. We have few people with the skills. If they get people from other urban areas, that we don't mind. If they say those people in your area do not qualify for those jobs, but if they qualify, if you have people with the skills within the district, let those people be considered first. Not taking people from Kitwe, from Chingola, or from Lusaka. Where will our people get employment? So, I think I can go forward. Then we come to the post status of feeder roads. In the this causes the delay of delivery of farm inputs to the farmers and also the collection of farm produce to safe storage facilities. This therefore poses a great danger to food security in the district and the province as a whole. Further, the poor road network has contributed to the high cost of commodities in the district, which has in turn raised the cost of living. Yeah, most of our feeder roads are very, very poor. I think the problem is that we didn't engage as a government our cooperative partners in time. This time, we are trying by all means to bring everybody, all the stakeholders on board. Just recently, 2 weeks ago, where they called all the people, were written to all the people operating in Fanyama. That's many companies, as well as non-government organizations. So we had a meeting to find a solution how we can best develop the district. As I have said here, most roads are inaccessible. During farm input program, when seeds are being distributed to the district, or when fertilizer is brought to the district, sometimes we become very stranded where to put our fertilizer. For example, last year, the government sent a good number of bags of fertilizer to the district. But then, we were not able to keep them. There was no storage facility. We were stranded. The vehicles were there almost 1 week without being offloaded because we had nowhere to put the fertilizer. Until I was forced to ask the Chinese who were constructing a high school at Lufanyama. So they refused to give me to release what the hall. We wanted to use the school hall for the newly constructed school. But then they said they cannot do that because they have to hand over the hall to the government when it is well completed. They said if you put the treasure there, they were going to spoil the building. But then it was very difficult. We had no alternative. So just for the situation, we put the fertilizer in the school hall, and after the exercise, after farmers had got their fertilizer, the roof was spoiled due to moisture, which was coming especially from urea top dressing. Those who have used our fertilizer, they know that urea has got high nitrogen content. So the sealing body, entire sealing body of the school hall collapsed. So then I was put into problems. Say, we told you to say we cannot use this. So now can you find a way of repairing this? And then even the floor also became bleached because of the fertilizer. So this year we have the same. We have the. I'm sure we are going to experience the same problem. That's why I called the stakeholders so that together we can find a solution. Now I talked to our cooperative partners, especially the mines. I gave them. I gave each other assignments. Kajiamu, we are given to grade some of the filter roads. As I said, the roads are very, very bad. I'm happy to say that there was a good response from Kajam. They have started grading the filter roads, and right now, as I'm speaking, many are there working on the roads. Then we discussed with the Miku mine to help us in constructing the food storage, but I have not yet received a response. I also asked the Chulma mine to work together with Miku mine to construct the food storage shed where we can put our farm inputs, our seeds, our fertilizer, but nothing. So when I was trying to make a follow-up, I went to them, asked them, I went to Grizzly. They told me to say, no, you didn't put it in written. So I said, no, that's simple. I went and put it in written. So I'm just waiting for the response from these other mines. But otherwise, in terms of corporate social responsibility, we get from even Greasy men, they give us sometimes and so on, but they help us mostly in these national programs like HIV/AIDS, maybe Independence Day celebration, Freedom Day, and so on. When we are organizing national programs concerning national events, they do assist us, but not as much as we expect. For example, at times you are asking maybe you are asking for a certain amount of money so that you can enable people in the villages to travel to where the functions are supposed to take place. You find that maybe a big company contributes 1,000 kwacha. Then this contributes 2,000 kwacha. Then you are stranded. You don't have enough money to transport the people. Because there are certain functions whereby we need the presence of everybody. Because they need to have access to information. It's during those gatherings that we can sensitize the people on a number of things. But if you are not helped much, Then our district will never go, never go forward. We need people, when we ask for assistance, let them help us so that at least together with them we are able to sensitize our people in a lot of things. So, I talked about the lack of employment. We don't have many industries apart from the mines and then the forestry department. That's all. We don't have many industries. So most of the people are unemployed, and you know the results of unemployment. If a person is not employed, if a person is not doing anything, he is tempted to do something which is not desirable to the community. Apart from government departments which are not fully developed, the district has very few companies that provide employment and other community services to the residents. It is government's policy to create an enabling environment to the investors so that their business can grow and help with the creation of employment, reduction of poverty, and increase literacy in the district. That I talked about to say, we do not have we don't have companies to employ our people. So this is about the corporate social responsibilities offered by our people. As I said, we get assistance from Greece, Kajao Mine, but then we get most of our assistance from Kajao Mine. Most of the time, when we go to ask them, they really will come us. They will come us, and we have very good relationship with the Kajao Mine. So, as you can see from this diagram here, this is ongoing. They are corporate responsibilities. Ongoing. They start from the workplace. While they are looking at their workplace, they also look at the needs of the community, where they can assist, where it is possible for them to assist the rent assistance. Then from there, they also look at the environment, what they can do in order to improve the environment. Then from there, when they produce their MROs, whatever, this is taken to markets, is sold, and then some of the profits are plowed back into the community. But what I'm saying is that we still need a lot of assistance from our corporate partners to at least help us in improving the especially the road infrastructures and even the storage shed, and giving employment to our local people, so that at least when they are productively engaged in certain activities, they will refrain from doing things which are not desirable. Okay, I can go ahead. The government agenda to alleviate poverty, fight disease, and illiteracy in the district cannot be achieved in isolation without the involvement of other stakeholders and the cooperating partners. It is in this regard that all companies operating within the district have been encouraged to take up corporate social responsibilities seriously. Kajao Mining Limited, a subsidiary of Gemfields PLC, being one of the largest gemstone mines in the terms of size and the operations, is therefore the center of focus by the community as a source of sustainable development in the area through corporate social responsibility projects. So as I said, we are now in very good terms with the Kajam. They are helping us in every respect. We hope this area is going to continue. And that they are going to look at this bigger project that we have, especially that of fertilizer storage shed. Because when we are given fertilizer, we do not have anywhere to put it. So we definitely need that storage. We are also asking from these other companies, the Grizzly, the Chiruma Mines, and so on, to come to our aid. We don't want our people to suffer. They produce a lot of maize. In 2011, a lot of maize was bent. A lot of maize, a number of bags were bent because they could not be transported to national storage facilities due to bad status of the feeder roads. Even last year, we found it very difficult to transport some farm produce from Kambirombiro. So farmers had just to use their initiative to sell their maize. They didn't, most of it was not sold to the government, but they had plenty of maize. But they had to go to transport it. It was a big problem. However, the government is also trying to help the district in rehabilitating our poor status of our roads. The council, the Fanyama District Council, they have bought a grader, but it's not yet in the country. But anytime, maybe this week, they may receive it. So this is going to at least they are going to make sure that some of the bad roads are graded. So, of course, well, they have to work together with our cooperative partners. Okay. So this this diagram is simply saying that all the activities that are undertaken together, if they say we successfully do this, all these activities that we have in the Fanyama to result in sustainable development. And as a cooperative partner, Gemfuels PLC through we are in this. This we did. All the cooperative social responsibility projects undertaken by Kajam have been identified by communities so involved in consultation with the central government. Because when you are doing something, you have to consult the owners of the place because they are experts. For example, if they say you see that they dig a well somewhere. Because maybe as an expert you think that that's the place where we find the water. The people are not going to drink that water because maybe that's the place where they buried their grandfather and they wouldn't like to drink water from there. So we have to listen to the experts, what they need. So the local government and tradition leaders, all the corporate social responsibility projects have been planned and executed in consultation and partnership to the concerned communities. The company has never imposed any project on any community. Just as I've said, you don't have to impose projects on your own people. People know their priority. They know what they should be given first. Like this time, our priority is on the roads and then also on the construction of fertilizer storage shed. That's our main need. Thank you. Oh, thank you very much.